Electric vehicles are all the rage with some drivers, but it's their range that's concerning others, especially in the cold.
So just how big of a problem is battery power in our freezing temperatures? Gordon Severson spoke with EV owners and researchers to find out.
It's a cold, snowy day in Minneapolis, and Amy Gustafson is getting ready for a drive.
This is the Kia EV6.
Her pride and joy.
So this is new in the U.S. this year.
New, so it's never experienced a Minnesota winter before.
It's ready to drive.
Ready to go out in the cold to see how the battery holds up.
Puts me down in about the 250-something range.
A drop from around 300 miles during the summer.
Because you're using a lot of electricity just to heat the car.
And driving in the snow. Gustafson says the range really depends on how much you run the heater.
If you run that real high, that's going to use as much or even more energy than you use for the drive itself.
On average, Gustafson says she loses about 25% of her range during the winter.
Yep.
Which is a lot better than the Tesla she bought 5 years ago.
You know, with the Tesla, I would say that I was probably seeing more like 40% less. My 2017 Tesla didn't have some of the same technology that helps to boost my range in this vehicle.
That's what Gustafson has seen with her experience. But what about other drivers?
The colder it gets, or even the hotter it gets, the more it's going to be impacted.
Alex Nizek is an engineer with Consumer Reports. He and his team recently tested 4 electric vehicles in 3 different temperatures.
We did a cold day kind of in the middle of winter. It was maybe 15 degrees or so. And then we also did in the springtime, about 65 degrees. And then also in the summer when it was between 80 and 85 degrees.
They saw the highest range during the summer and the lowest during the winter.
In the wintertime, compared to the EPA range ratings for these vehicles, we saw on average about a 25% reduction in the range.
With the EVs averaging around 170 to 190 miles on a full charge at 15 degrees.
You'll probably reduce it even further as the temperatures get colder.
EV owners say you can also lose range by just sitting out in the cold with your car not even running. So we got our hands on this Tesla and we're going to test that out. It's about 10 o'clock in the morning and 22 degrees outside. And right now the range is reading at 161 miles. So I'm going to go into work, come out at the end of the day and see if that number changes.
So it's the end of the day. It's about 6 o'clock and right now it's reading about 145 miles. That means that just sitting here in the parking lot, the car lost 16 miles of range. Nizek says one trick to get more range is to warm up your vehicle while it's plugged in, so you're using the power from your charger and not from your battery. You'll also get better range driving on city streets versus the highway.
Stopping and starting a lot really gives you a lot more range.
That's because EVs use regenerative braking.
Every time I take my foot off the gas, the vehicle is then recouping power from that friction in the motors.
So we've shown that EVs do lose range in the cold, but is it a reason to be concerned?
People talk about range anxiety, and it's interesting. You see some people get very worried about it.
Worried that they might run out of power.
I've never gotten to the point where I'm worried about being stranded.
Gustafson says it's never happened to her. With her charger at home, she gets around 40 miles of range every hour she's charging, so she can start each morning with a full battery.
For most drivers, if you're not driving 300 miles a day, it doesn't really matter that much.
And when she goes on long trips,
you do a little more planning.
Finding charging stations along the way, and if you need to, you can charge using a simple everyday outlet. It just won't charge as fast.
Charging started.
I think most people have to ask themselves realistically, how do they drive, where do they drive on a daily basis?
Gordon Severson, Carol 11 News.
Well, the talk surrounding electric vehicles is so prevalent right now, Vice President Kamala Harris is coming to St. Cloud this Thursday to highlight the administration's investment in electric vehicles. If you want to take a deeper look at that study from Consumer Reports, we have a link posted on our website.